Advertising for an apprentice is very difficult. The perfect apprentice will be organised, motivated, punctual, reliable. It's hard because you can't actually say double-ended dildo show on Facebook.
Some people do this sort of work and it's just a little thing on the side, or they keep it on the down low and it's a big secret. But Bonnie has no secrets. She lives it and breathes it.
I've done shows from Darwin right down to Brisbane, everywhere. All I need is a girl to help me make this more fun. The industry is complex, but most of the time I'm butt naked in the middle of the bush. Hi, I'm Bonnie. I'm the one and only Bonnie Tonic, and I live in central Queensland, and I'm an Outback stripper. This week we're going to Mackay. You need to be prepared. You can't just piss off into the middle of nowhere and not have what you need. Sometimes I've got to drive hours and hours west. I've even driven out to Mount Isa. That was pretty full on. That takes about 10 hours. I'm an old hat at it. I've been doing it for 17 years now, so I kind of feel like it's just second nature. When I do a bucks party, I'll usually rock up to a room full of screaming guys. If it's not a room, it'll be a paddock full of them. Come out, woo, rip your giant coat off, start dancing, kick your legs around, shake your boobs. I feel like I'm on a Broadway stage or something, you know? Well, when I was growing up, I was just an awkward tomboy, and every day I'd walk past the titty bar and you'd hear all the commotion and you'd hear all the screaming and yelling. But as soon as I was old enough, I went into that titty bar, got me tits out. It was exciting, and I can't lie to me mother. She knows me too well, so I rang her, and on the phone she basically said, "Oh my God, that's it, I'm disowning you." Oh. And then like 5 minutes later, "Oh my God, I love you, just don't talk to strangers, don't take drugs." We were raised sort of hippie, so we weren't embarrassed. Like, we're all adults, if we're all safe and comfortable, well, they're just boobs. Hashtag best boobs in CQ.
Yeah, she's known by her boobs, I think. And I've heard, like, there's some people say, like, oh, they're not real, but no, I think they are. My name's Melinda Slingsby, I'm 45 years old, and I'm also known as Malibu, but I don't go down easy like the drink. Bonnie, I've known for about probably 15 years. Oh, she's outrageous. She has no filter, but she's a lovely girl. She's one of the few kind, not mean girls that you find in the industry. She understands the concept that it's a memory that people are making when they book their bucks party and stuff like that. And these days it's hard to learn the art of strictures, I guess.
There's no other girls here. The job always comes back to me. I've been trying to get an apprentice. I have advertised on LinkedIn, I've advertised on Gumtree, I've advertised on Facebook. It's difficult. People don't take it seriously. You could be making $500 an hour. I've had a couple of girls apply. Some have been lovely and they're like, "Hey, I can totally get topless, but I can't do nude." I'm like, "Well, we can totally do that, but you're probably not going to make any money." Like, I do triple X shows.
How would I explain Bonnie's show? Explicit? Full on? Hardcore?
You can do what is called controlled touching. So if people are being polite and courteous, you can shake your boobs in their face. We call that a motorboat, that's industry terms. You need to be in control of the show and of what's going on, but still being able to have a good time. You need to know what's going on around you.
Have you had any scary moments?
Oh, a few times. I've been up at pubs where guys have grabbed me on the box, but a guy lifted my skirt over my head and licked me from front to back. You practice your right hook with that. A lot of times over the years, people think that it's okay to, like, they don't realise that's actually sexual assault. What people think is that because you're a stripper, that that's okay, that you don't deserve the same level of respect and courtesy as other women.
What's the biggest misconception, I guess?
That we're prostitutes? Because we're not. You, one or the other, you've got to do one or the other.
Guys ring me when they book jobs all the time, and how much for extras? It's like, well, that's not what that is, mate. I get slut-shamed a lot. I'd be trying to get my groceries out, and people would be, get your tits out, you slut, yelling, ah, you fucking dog. I mean, how horrible is that? Who would say that to anyone? And I don't have to be ashamed because what I'm doing isn't bad. My main focus isn't the stripping, it's I want to make people happy. I'm at my happiest when I'm watering my garden, I'm wearing my Crocs, I'm watching my flowers grow. The sun shines, mate. I feel like I'm in heaven.
The Crocs drive me insane. Bonnie, the Crocs need to go. I did ask her recently about what her plans were. You know, I think she said to me that she wants to try and wrap it up by the time she's 40. But we'll see about that.
Let's just see if the girls hold up that long. I'm not doing too bad at the moment, 35, and they're not down around my knees yet. You need to like who you are. I'm lucky, I don't have to hide my lifestyle from my family. I can understand why for a young woman that may be intimidating to start with. What if my brother sees it, or what if my boyfriend doesn't like it? Well, get another one. Fuck him. Shit, if I cared what people think, I probably would have quit a million years ago.